Hi, it's Leah Katan, and this is how I make my unique candy singles. After my last rotating cuff tutorial, some of you guys have been saying things like,
"That looks so hard. It's too intense."
But it's okay. That's what your girlfriend said when she last saw me too. I think there might be a misconception out there that think it costs extra to make your candy special. So today I'm going to show you guys how I usually make my singles. It honestly doesn't cost a lot, and it makes a huge difference. So let's get started. So the first place I like to get my beads from is the Dollar Store. There's a lot of different beads available from there. So what I usually do is I just buy a bunch of everything when I see there's new styles out. Some of the classic ones they have that I like using are the words, crystal beads, and the metallic pony beads. And these I believe they don't have it in every single store, but I do like using these metallic balls and these metallic stars. I also like to go to the baby sections. There's a lot of things you can use as decoration beads. The second place I like to go to buy my beads is Hobby Lobby. I usually stock up a whole year worth of beads when they do have 50% off sale because they don't have it very often. But even if you missed all the sales, the price point is still very reasonable. If you want any recommendation, I personally really like using Tri Beads and Sunburst Beads. So now I'm going to make an example of how I can make my candy just by using the materials I mentioned earlier. So let's start with a simple one first. Let's say if you're a guy or if you just want your candy to look clean and simple, you can try using Tri Beads. I love the movement it brings to the single. And for some reason when I'm looking at Tri Beads, it kind of reminds me of a jelly texture. If you want more Leah style, I usually like to add Tri Beads right next to my words. And then Sunburst Beads, Tri Beads again. After that, I just like to mix and match a little bit of everything. After I'm done, I like to add a little charm. I just feel like by doing that, it helps to stand out from all the other candies. Since I'm going to count down in a few days, I'm also gonna include those candy in this video, just in case you guys need an idea of how to make your candy. So the first category you can use is the event type. Things like the name of the event or anything related to the event you're going to. So for me, it's countdown, so I just wrote something that is related to New Year or countdown. The second category is supply type. Sometimes I like to put in things that are useful during the events. So I put an emergency blanket just in case somebody needs it, or even if I need it. The third category can be something about yourself. I don't know, maybe some fun or good things about yourself. For example, I have fancy bitch because I'm a fancy bitch. Disco ball because I'm a disco ball. I'm baby because I'm baby. Big D energy, that's me all day every day. And some of y'all need that shit! The next category can be wishes. Maybe some wishes that you think people will need. You know, some heartwarming stuff. The last category I can think of is just some fun stuff. It can be anything that you're feeling or something that you think is funny. For me, it's some necklaces and some cuffs. So yeah, I just want to include these into my videos. So that's it for today's video. I hope you guys learned to utilize more special beads to make more special candy. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye!